Ecce Homo is the figure that was in Trafalgar Square over the millennium, the first sculpture on the fourth plinth, and I'd been approached in 1998 about the idea of a work that might become a permanent sculpture in the square, because Trafalgar Square is the place of the crowd, of the populace, the mob, if you like, the place of celebration, and in the past of public executions, it seemed appropriate to have Christ at this moment where Pilate has left him to mob justice. And it was, I suppose, shortly after the Bosnian War, and so I wanted to depict Christ as a political prisoner and someone whose hair had been shorn, but who has his eyes closed, so he's not fully available to us, and I wanted it hopefully to resound for believers, for which this is where Christ is facing up to his destiny, and to unbelievers, to us in the square, our responsibilities as citizens, not to condemn, but to understand.
My early work was kind of, looking very much at identity and national identity at the time, because, we're in the middle of, the miners' strike. We just had the Falklands War in Britain, British National Party. It was, there were a lot of things at stake at the time, and there was a very right-wing government with Margaret Thatcher, and there was a bogus history that was being presented to people. So a lot of the work was kind of to do with that at the time, but also finding myself as an artist and trying things out in different media as well. I suppose I was in the painting department at Chelsea School of Art when I went there, when things were a bit more delineated, and then I found myself, I think I can make a sculpture. And then when the first affordable camcorders came in, one could make films in a sort of very fresh, almost naive way. So all those things just kind of widened the possibilities of how and what the work could address. And then some things, were instances in my life that I couldn't just kind of ignore. And the it paintings we have here, I suppose that came out of this long series of self-portraits which are in the following room in this exhibition, but in which I found my own little bit of kind of machinery, really, for creating. I had these canvases that are my span and double my height, and then painted with both hands simultaneously, black and white. So sometimes you just need a number of restrictions to actually find a freedom. It is trying to make sense best I can of my life. In English we have this word I, which is the word we have for ourselves that we share with everyone else's word for themselves. So I liked the paradoxical nature of that and what the embodiment of a capitalised I represented. anthology of English poetry for every line that begins with I. Stones kind of bleed into this piece, which is called the unconscious. In a sense, that's literally what they are, these people. I started thinking about how I have, everyone's kind of fallen asleep on public transport at some point, or seen people asleep. And that says something, I think, quite nice and positive about our civic culture, and that we feel safe enough and relaxed enough to be in a crowd of strangers, and we can just lose ourselves entirely and be completely vulnerable. My work, I think, is about hopefully still carrying the sense of having noticed something, or, you know, or a recognition of something. Or something that becomes an imperative to have it made, and maybe share that, just that sense of, oh, have you noticed this? Or, you know, come and have a look at this.